Hi guys, my name is Ruti from guidedppc, and today we will learn how you can set up Google Ads dynamic remarketing tag for your Shopify store using Google Tag Manager. So basically we need to set up dynamic remarketing tag to dynamically retarget to the person who interacted with our product. Let's suppose if someone view a category of product, search a product, view a single product, add to cart a product, proceed to checkout, even purchase that product. So in that case, we can retarget that user so that the user being targeted to the same product that was interacted with him, so that he will purchase that product faster. So to set up dynamic remarketing ads, we need to set up the dynamic remarketing tag before. So basically, through the dynamic remarketing tag, we need to pass the product level data. Like if a product being interacted, then we need to send the product ID, the product value. I mean the ID is mandatory to dynamically retarget that product. So basically the ID should match with your product field ID in your GMC, so that it can identify the product and user to show the ads. So the introduction is will gonna vary high if I deep dive into. So I hope you may know about the basic of dynamic remarketing campaign, how this works. So without any delay, let's get started.
Okay, so first of all, open your Tag Manager account. Then go to Tags. Then create a new tag. Click here, new button. Then just name your tag. Okay, then click here, tag configuration. Then choose your Google Ads remarketing, this option. Then we need the conversion ID. So you can get your conversion ID by going to your Google Ads. So open your Google Ads, go to Tools and Settings, then Audience Manager. Then go to your data sources. So then click on here inside the Google Ads tab, click on the dotted icon, click on edit source. Then just scroll down and you can save the code. Basically I have already created the code, so that's why I am not changing it. I have already selected the remarketing everything. So in your case, the edit code option won't be visible. It would be like create code, set up new, just like that. Just save this. Then you will get the tag setup details. So click here, use Google Tag Manager. Then you will get the conversion ID. So copy your conversion ID, then paste it here. Then conversion level is optional, not required. Then check mark this box to use dynamic remarketing tag. Check mark this, then it will open some more option, event name, event values, and event items. So basically these are the dynamic remarketing data we need to pass if someone opened a product, interacted a product. So let's suppose if someone viewed a product, we have to send the event name as view item, event value, the product value, and inside the event items, we have to send the ID. Okay. So basically, we have to send the details as a data layer so that we can use those data in the Google Tag Manager. So I have created a data layer code so that you can use inside your Shopify store. So here is the tag. So I will add the document link inside the description below so you can use this data layer. So first of all, go to your Shopify admin, then go to online store. Some cases online store may not visible here. Then you can click here, use the search box, just search online. Then you can definitely find here by using the search if it is not present here. So click here anyway. Then you can get your active theme. This is my active theme. Then click on the three dotted icon. Then click edit code. Then scroll down. You will get snippet option. Expand this. Add a new snippet and name your snippet exactly same as it written here. You can copy the exact name and paste it here. Okay. Then you can copy the rest code. So let me you need to change the code a bit if your product ID is not same. So the data layer is set up in such a way that it will work for 90% of Shopify store. So you can verify it though. So go to your GMC products and check your IDs, product IDs, and check the format. So in some cases, in like 90% of cases, the product ID should be like Shopify, like this, Shopify underscore country code, then underscore item ID, underscore item variant ID. So if you see like Shopify underscore your country code, then some number, then underscore, then some more numbers, then you can use this data layer code. If not, then you cannot use this data layer code. So basically in 90% of case the code follow the same structure. So just verify this and you can use this. So first of all, you can change your country code. So if your country code is India, then you can type your IN inside the single quotation mark. If you are targeting UK, then you can type UK. If you are targeting Australia, you can type AU. If you are targeting CA, then you can type CA. So same for other countries too. That's it. Then copy the entire code from here to here. Then just copy inside this script. Save this. Now go to your theme.liquid. Now you need to copy the next code. So copy this code, copy from the curly braces to curly braces, copy, then go to here, then inside the theme.liquid, you can get your head tag. So this is our Google Tag Manager code. So basically, if you haven't set up your Google Tag Manager code, then it won't work. Go ahead and watch my previous lecture on how to set up Google Tag Manager code for Shopify. Then only you can use this option. So after the Google Tag Manager code, like the end Google Tag Manager code, you can paste that code. Just paste this and save this. That's it. then close this window. Then we need to paste another piece of code to the checkout. So simply go to settings, then go to checkouts, then scroll down, then inside the order status page you can get this type of box, and inside this box you can paste the code right below. If you have some code, you can paste that code all the down below. So go to the document. Here is the code for checkout. Just copy. Before copying, you need to change your country code like same. So in my case it is US. So change your country code. If you are targeting IN India, then you can type IN. So follow the same introduction I have said. Then you can copy the whole code from here to here, then go to here, just paste this, save this. Okay, now you can close this window. Now the tag manager will get the data layer code, the product level information. So you can even check whether the data layer is passing or not. Go to here. You can check it later. You can set up directly. So first of all, for the event name, you can click on this icon. Then here, select this one, event. It will dynamically pull all the events. Then for the event value, it should be the product value. Click here and click here to create a new variable so that we can dynamically fetch the product price. Just name it, click on configuration, and from here choose data layer variable. Then variable name should be guided PPC, GUIDED PPC. Do not misspell it, unless it won't work. Guided PPC dot value, value. So exactly write it exactly that I am writing here. So if you misspell anything, if you miss a single word, then it won't work. Okay, so make sure the name is exactly matching. Guided PPC dot value, save this. Then for the item, click here, and same, we need to create a new variable. So select new variable option, then name your variable dy items, then choose again the data layer variable. Then for here, name it guided PPC dot items. Okay, so it is items. Then save this. Basically I will show you how we can how I am naming the things exactly. So I will show you when I will verify this code. That's it. Then scroll down, and for the triggering, click here to create a new triggering. Name the trigger dy gets remarketing. Then from here choose custom event. Okay, so here I have written the custom event for you guys. Just copy the custom event, the highlighted words, then paste it here, and don't make you know, make sure to check mark this option, use regex matching, check mark this, then save this. Save the entire code. That's it, you are good to go. All things has been set up. Now we can check whether the code is passing or not, whether the tag is passing the product information or not. Click here, create a new preview window. Enter your website URL, then connect. So here is our website. So now we have to view a product. Let's suppose first of all open a category page. Okay, so this is our category page, and to go to this tab, then continue, then you can see tag fired, gas dy remarketing. So dynamic remarketing tag has been fired, and here is the event name. Now open a product page. Now let's check whether it has fired or not. So here even it has fired, and event is view item. You can even check further if the IDs values are passing or not. Click here, then choose the event view item for this case, because we are viewing a single product. So now we can check everything. The item ID, which is Shopify underscore numbers, then underscore variant ID, which is numbers again. Then the event value is 250. Let's check whether the product price is 250 or not. So this is 250. So everything is passing, value is passing, ID is passing, and event name is passing. That's it. So we are good to go, and we have also verified the things. Okay. That's it. So you can close this window. Then the final step is submit the tag, unless it won't work. So make sure to submit the container. Click here, submit. Then you're gonna publish it directly. You can skip this if you want. You can name this publish. That's it. So in this way you can set up your Google Ads dynamic remarketing tag for your Shopify store using Google Tag Manager. So I hope you like this video. If you have liked this, please thumbs up and share this video with your friend, family members, colleague, wherever you can. Just spread the value so that they will learn the stuff. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me inside the comment below. You can comment that, and make sure to subscribe this channel to watch these kind of valuable tutorial ahead. And that's it for today, and see you again. Bye bye.